The narrator of today's program would like to apologize for the poor pronunciation of names and places. Today, I shall answer a most pressing question. I have studied for years and traveled across the world to bring you the answer. What is the difference between a violin and a fiddle? The answer will be revealed right after this commercial break! Welcome back, and as I was saying, the answer is nothing. The violin is associated with classical music while the fiddle is associated with country music, but other than that, there is no real difference. So the fiddler on the roof could have actually been a violinist on the roof. Now, we'll move into our next section of the show. In this next section, we'll go over the history of this instrument. The violin, or rather, bowed-stringed instruments, originated in Central Asia. The first predecessor to the modern violin appeared in Europe in the 16th century. The oldest violin in existence was made by luthier, a violin maker, named Andrea Amari. Amari made 24 violins for the King of France, Charles IX, who the violin was named after. From 1600 to 1760, also known as the Baroque Era, the violin was popular with both nobility and street performers for its size and melodic tune. The most important makers during this era were Stradivari, Amari, Guardinari del Gesu, and Montignana. There were many more, but the most sought-after violins were from these creators. The record amount ever paid for a violin, as of January 2013, was $18 million for a Guardinari del Gesu violin. After the break, we'll talk more in depth about Stradivari and his career. Antonio Stradivari is considered the most significant and greatest artisan in his field. He lived in Cremona, Italy from 1644 to 1737. When Stradivari was still the pupil of Niccolò Amati, he created violins the same way his teacher did, small in size, with a yellow varnish. In 1666, Stradivari began to label the violins that he made. Later, he played around with the size and look, making them larger and giving them a dark, rich varnish. Stradivari created some of his best works from 1700 to the 1720s, which is referred to as his golden period. To this day, his creations are regarded as the finest bowed stringed instruments of all time.